were completely massacred, what happened was that the mobs went rioting through the Jewish ghetto. They would pull babies apart from their limbs till they broke. They would rape women and daughters in front of the families.
They pulled the Jew among all passengers in the bus. Who is the Jew? And they did the Jew out. They killed them outside the bus.
Who killed the Arab? The Jews are the dogs of the Arabs. Or Idbah Yahud, slit the throat of the Jews, slaughter the Jews. These were not only on posters, but the people were chanting them. And this was scary to see a crowd coming towards you chanting, Idbah Yahud, kill the Jews.
Rasti ve'ebrat simahara, rasti ve'ebrat simahara, yashka suti, harbitzu ad kama shin maslain. זה הסימן, תראה, רצו לחטוף את הידיים, את הרגליים, את הראש, כמו מפה, עם גרזלים, עד שנמאס להם, וחשבו שאני מת.
The persecution of the governments of Arab countries made the Jews in Arab countries desire to leave their origin country, but they didn't how, because no country was ready to receive them. So when the State of Israel was established, suddenly we have a shelter and the Jews came to Israel.
When I came to this desert, there were there nearly 4,000 people in the desert, in that camp, that terrible camp. There was only sand and very little huts that they live in. They never complained. Why? Because they waited. They hoped. They knew that tomorrow we shall be saved. Tomorrow we shall go to Israel. On Shabbat, we read that part of the Torah. We read that word, Va'esa etchem al kanfe nesharim va'avi etchem. And I shall take you, you know, with the eagle wings, to Israel. And the Sunday, the eagle, or if you want, the aeroplane, came and took the first wave.
They were put into tents, wooden huts, more than 10 years. Those Jews were in tents as refugees.
If I say, who are the Middle East refugees, people don't think at all about the Jews. All the people think about are the Palestinians.
Many people ask me, why do you call yourself forgotten refugees? It is interesting to note that in the history of the Middle East, we have been totally cut out of the picture.
The United Nations General Assembly since 1947 has adopted 687 resolutions on the Arab-Israeli conflict. 101 of those resolutions dealt with refugees, but all those 101 resolutions dealt with Palestinian refugees only. It's astonishing to realize that not one resolution, not one of these resolutions ever dealt with the issue of Jewish refugees from Arab lands.
We were really the forgotten refugees, and nobody talked about us. And, you know, we were really humiliated, and we didn't get much attention also. We felt like a great injustice has been done to us.
We want our children to remember us, so that we can perpetuate the memory of all these 1 million Jews were kicked out of the Arab world, and they will never return.
I think the only path to peace is when people can open their hearts and listen to the stories of everyone involved. And this means both the positive things, the points of connection between Arabs and Jews, where there's an overlap of culture, and also the points of oppression.
The Arab governments have taken away our homes. They've taken away our culture. They have destroyed our communities. But they can never take away our spirit to fight for justice.
Each human wants to live. All human wants to live. He wants his family, his children, to continue living. And if we continue this way of killing each other, of these troubles, and so on and so forth, I mean, there is no hope for them, there is no hope for us.
What's important to me is that the stories of everybody be told, and that everybody's history be recognized, and everybody's rights be honored.